Good morning to all. Welcome to another session of this online class. So in the last class, we discussed about the chapter, the final speech by Charlie Chaplin in the movie The Great Dictator. And today, we are going to focus on the new chapter from the module 3, which is the Letter to Adolf Hitler by M.K. Gandhi. So this is another segment or another module in this paper signatures. So the third module is regarded as the combination of chapters from letters and diaries. So today we have the chapter which is the Letter to Adolf Hitler. So just like an introduction to this module, we have to focus on the title or the type of this chapter, which is the letter. So what is a letter? A letter is a message written to another pertaining to someone matter of common concern. So oru letter or kathu ennu parayunnathu nammal endeyum oru karyam arikkano allengi adu oru invite cheyan vendittu angane oru aavashyathinu vendittu oraalu matta aalukku aikkunna oru sambhavam aayittanu letter ne poduve nammal kaanunnathu. So here too we have another letter. So this letter is very important in the on the basis of the content of this letter, because this letter is to Adolf Hitler, and also this letter is written by M.K. Gandhi. So that is a major difference that we have to focus on. And here we are talking about literary letters that is published because of the by a well-known person wrote, and also because it defines the times in which it was written. So these letters, or the category of letters in this module, we can see that these letters is regarded as the literary letters. So endana literary letters adayide literature paramayite allengi oru athra sahithya paramayite adilu koodile adodoppan thanne oru nalloru message allengi nalloru content illa letters aanu namukku ee chapter ee module mottullathu. So the forms of letters is regarded as the literary letters that is published because a well-known person, and all these letters are written by the well-known persons, and these letters encourage the readers to think critically on various issues and themes. So ee letters kodudalayittum ee letters inde oru intention parayune critical aayittu chindikkan vendittu pratheechu various issues and themes pala vidhamaya issues um themes inum koodi focus cheyan vendittu adine kurichokke onnu critically evaluate cheyan vendittulla letters aanu idil koodudalum. So this chapter, which is this Letter to Adolf Hitler, also focuses or it also signifies like this matter, and also these letters it became a way of self expression and exchange of ideas with like minded others. And also under this topic we have only two chapters, which is letters. The first one is the Letters to Adolf Hitler by M.K. Gandhi, and also we have another chapter which is also a letter in this module, which is the Letter from the Mothers of Nanjimbarambu to the Supreme Court. So these are the two chapters which is in this module, which is regarded as the forms of letters. So we discussed about the topic letters in this module. So now we are moving to this chapter itself, which is the Letter to Adolf Hitler by M.K. Gandhi. So before moving to this the author's detail, I am going to introduce this chapter, just give an outline to this chapter. So this prescribed letter was written on 24 December 1940, and Gandhiji begins this letter by addressing Hitler as dear friend. So these two characters, especially Gandhiji and also Adolf Hitler, both are contemporaries during the 1940s, and he addresses Hitler as dear friend, and he affirms Hitler that he has no enmity towards Hitler, and that his business in life for the last 33 years is to create friendship universally by befriending mankind regardless of race. So their attitude or their intention was different in their thinking or in their activity, in which Adolf Hitler was more aggressive and whereas the Gandhiji only promoted the kind of non-violence and this kind of focus on the peace and the well-being of the human beings. So here there is the change of their attitude, but he affirms that Hitler, that he has no enmity towards Hitler. So it is very important, and that his business and in his life for the last 33 years is to create friendship universally by befriending mankind regardless of race and also color or creed. And he seeks the attention of Hitler towards the humanity who live under the influence of that doctrine of universal friendship views of Hitler's action. So here this lecture is like the to focus the Hitler in order to just focus on the humanity throughout the world, and also to influence of that the doctrine of universal friendship view of Hitler's action. So here in this chapter we can see that the intention of this lecture to Hitler by Gandhi is only to get a kind of connection or to a kind of friendship between them in order to discuss about the kind of this universal things which includes the kind of humankind and also their attitude to dealing the all the problems during that time. So this is just like a informal letter by M.K. Gandhi to Adolf Hitler, and throughout this letter he focuses on the major points regarding his life and also some advices to Hitler also. So that's regarding just an outline to this chapter, the lecture to Adolf Hitler. So this lecture by M.K. Gandhi to Adolf Hitler, we can see that this lecture, the intentional lecture, is to just to get a clear contact between these two persons, especially Hitler and Gandhi. And he affirms Hitler that he has no enmity towards Hitler, and that his business in life for the last 33 years is to create friendship universally by befriending mankind regardless of race, color and creed. So this is the intention of this lecture. And then Gandhi also states that there is no doubt regarding his bravery or devotion to his fatherland, and that no one believe him to be a monster as described by his challenges. So this is just an outline to this lecture. So besides that, we are going to just focus on the introduction to this author itself in this chapter, letter to Adolf Hitler. So Gandhiji and Adolf Hitler are our contemporaries who represent the opposite extremes of human character. So I already discussed about this in which their attitude was a little bit different in their nature, in which they were contemporaries and who represent the opposite extremes of human character. So Hitlerum Gandhiji rendu perum contemporaries, adhaayathu samakaligamaya samayathu ore samayathu undayirunna rendu pramukha vyaktikalanu. Adorappum thanne avare avarude oru ethum valiya oru important point nammal focus cheyyanda endanengil, they represent the opposite extremes of human character. Appo avarku rendu perkum rendu tarathilulla oru human character aayirunnu, in which naan nerthu parna pole ഒന്ന് അഗ്രസീവും ഒന്ന് കുറച്ച് ഒരു പീസ്ഫുൾ മൈൻഡ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു അറ്റ്മോസ്ഫിയറുമായിരുന്നു. സോ ദീസ് ആർ ദി മേജർ പോയിൻറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു ഫോക്കസ് ഓൺ ദിസ് ചാപ്റ്റർ 2. സോ ഗാന്ധിജി ഈസ് കൺസിഡേർഡ് ദി പാരഗൺ ഓഫ് പേഷ്യൻസ് ആൻഡ് സാക്രിഫൈസ്, വൈൽ ഹിറ്റ്ലർ ഈസ് സിനോമിനസ് വിത്ത് ബ്രൂട്ടാലിറ്റി ആൻഡ് വയലൻസ്. So we all know the activities done by Hitler during the World War II, and by Gandhiji during the Indian independence struggle. So all these actions, we can point out these actions in a very systematic manner, in such a way that Gandhiji is considered as the paragon of patience and sacrifice, and whereas Hitler is regarded as the kind of this brutality and violence. So these two things, or these two points, are just like a opposite in its nature, in which one is just like a aggressive thing, and another one is just like a very humankind thing, or the mankind thing, or just like a peaceful thing. So that's regarding just an introduction to this chapter. And both of them were very powerful leaders of their times, who adopted diametrically opposed strategies for resistance and consolidation of power. So their intention was to resist the dominance by others. For example, in India, Gandhiji led the independence struggle in order to survive, in order to get freedom from British during the 1940s. So it means that their intention was to against the resistance, resistance and consolidation of power. And Gandhiji's policy was non-violent struggle, was unique as effective as well as it was effective to resisting the enemies. So we have a very motivational or inspirational kind of activity by Gandhiji during the Indian independence struggle, which is the non-violence. So this action was adopted as the one of the most effective, and it was a unique one during that time, and it is regarded as effective in resisting the enemies. And also he won the hearts of his followers through precept and practice. Okay, while comparing with between Gandhiji and Hitler, the Gandhiji's policies of non-violent struggle was unique, as it was a very effective, and also unique as well as immensely effective in resisting the enemies. Whereas Hitler, who is like a dictator, his policy was to impose the authority on his men, and also to fight against the enemies. So their intention or dealing these all kind of problems, especially the Indian independence struggle and also the World War II by Hitler, both these intention was very different in its nature. Basically, Gandhiji followed the kind of this non-violent violence, whereas Hitler followed the kind of this imposed the authority or the dictatorship on his man. And also Gandhiji believed in the kind of this egalitarianism, which means that the kind of this non-violent and peaceful mind, whereas Hitler believed in well-defined hierarchies. So it is very important to avoid of this kind of ego or this kind of the negative feelings, and only to focus on this kind of non-violence and this kind of especially the kind of peaceful kind of challenging or to accepting all the problems is very important, and it is regarded as Gandhiji's unique nature, and it was regarded as an effective technique to fight against the enemies. And Hitler believed in well-defined hierarchies. So their intention, basically, through this topic, just like a comparison between Gandhiji and Adolf Hitler, the basic thing is that their intention or dealing the activities or dealing the problems was entirely different in its nature. Especially Gandhiji followed the kind of this non-violence fight against the enemies, whereas the policy of Hitler was just like a dictatorship, or to impose the authorship on his men or his soldiers in a very brutal manner. So this is the major difference between Gandhiji and Adolf Hitler that we should focus on while discussing this chapter. So the second paragraph in this chapter, or the lecture to Adolf Hitler, by M.K. Gandhi, we can see that Gandhiji's non-violent method of resistance won international attention, earning him the title Mahatma, which is Sanskrit means great soul. So that his activity, particularly the policy of this kind of this activity, this kind of this non-violent method of resistance, it won the international attention, earning him to the title Mahatma. So the term Mahatma or the title Mahatma was just like an it represents the method of resistance which he used during the Indian independence struggle, which is kind of this non-violent method. Then the epithet was first applied to him in 1940 in South Africa after studying law in London, and he went to practice law in South Africa while he was 23. So just like some life events regarding Mahatma Gandhi, the first thing is that he just moved to South Africa in order to study law. So in 1914 he moved to South Africa. After studying law in London, he went to practice law in South Africa while he was 23. So he was studied in London to study the law, and then he went to practice the law in South Africa while he was 23. And his stint as a lawyer and in South Africa informed his ethical and political views. So he practiced the law in as a lawyer in South Africa, and it gives a clear idea, or it informed his ethical and political views during this practice. Then Gandhi first employed non-violent civil disobedience while in South Africa during the South African Indian community struggle for the civil rights in the wake of discrimination from the whites. So ee non-violence enna sambhavam adu koodile ഫസ്റ്റ് അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്തത് ഗാന്ധിജി സൗത്ത് ആഫ്രിക്കയിലെ ഈ ലോ പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന സമയത്തായിരുന്നു. എഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് ദി എസ്പെഷ്യലി ദി എഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് ദി സിവിൽ റൈറ്റ്സ് സ്ട്രഗിൾ ടു ദി സിവിൽ റൈറ്റ്സ് എസ്പെഷ്യലി ദി ഡിസ്ക്രിമിനേഷൻ ബൈ ദി വൈറ്റ്സ്. സോ അന്നും, അതായത് 1940 അല്ലെങ്കിൽ 1923 ആ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ കൂടിയും ഗാന്ധിജി പരീക്ഷിച്ച അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഗാന്ധിജിയുടെ ഒരു പോളിസി ആയിരുന്നു എന്ത്, നോൺ വയലൻസ് എന്നൊരു മെത്തേഡ്. സോ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് വെരി വെരി ഇഫക്റ്റീവ് ഡ്യൂറിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് ടൈം, ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻഫ്ലുവൻസ്ഡ് ബൈ ടോൾസ്റ്റോയ്. ഹി എസ്റ്റാബ്ലിഷ്ഡ് ആൻ ഐഡിയൽ കമ്മ്യൂണിറ്റി കോൾഡ് ടോൾസ്റ്റോയ് ഫാം നിയർ ജോൺസ്ബർഗ് ഇൻ 1910. സോ ഇറ്റ് മീൻസ് ദാറ്റ് he was inspired, Gandhiji was inspired by Tolstoy, and he established an ideal community which is called the Tolstoy Farm near Johannesburg in 1910, then where he developed his policy of peaceful struggle. So Gandhiji kurichu parayumbo ethum koodil nammal focus cheyanda sambhavam endanengil his intention or his activities in or implementing his policies. So ella policyum koodilum aalude Gandhiji enna oru mahalmavinte പോളിസി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നോൺ വയലൻസ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു പീസ്ഫുൾ ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് സ്ട്രഗിൾ, പീസ്ഫുൾ ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് ഡീലിംഗ് ഓൾ ദി ആക്ടിവിറ്റീസ്. സോ ദിസ് റിഗാർഡിംഗ് ദി ഗാന്ധിജിസ് പോളിസി. ആൻഡ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ഹിസ് റിട്ടേൺ ടു ഇന്ത്യ ഇൻ 1915 ഹി ഓർഗനൈസ്ഡ് പെസൻസ് ഫാമേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് അർബൻ ലേബേഴ്സ് ടു പ്രൊട്ടസ്റ്റ് അഗേൻസ്റ്റ് ദി എക്സസീവ് ലാൻഡ് ടാക്സ് ആൻഡ് ഡിസ്ക്രിമിനേഷൻ. സോ ആഫ്റ്റർ his return to India in 1915, he organized peasants, farmers and urban laborers to protest against the excessive land tax and discrimination. So during that time in 1915 onwards, the he was just coordinated some kind of struggles against the landlords. Especially they imposed the excessive land tax for these peasants and farmers in the especially the urban laborers, and against this excessive land tax and also the kind of discrimination, they especially the by the leadership of Gandhiji, he introduced the kind of this non-violent struggle against all this kind of activities, especially the excessive land tax and the discrimination. and assuming the leadership of the Indian National Congress in 1921, Gandhi led nationwide campaigns for various social causes and for achieving Swaraj or the self-rule. So it is also another important point regarding Gandhi. The first one was the non-violence and how he dealt the major problems, struggles in his life. The second point was regarding the Indian National Congress in 1921, and he led nationwide campaigns for various social causes and for achieving Swaraj or self-rule. So it is the major major intention of to get the freedom to India was to get the self-rule, which is the Swaraj for India. And he was assassinated by Nathuram Godse, which is a religious fanatic, on 13th October 1948. So this is regarding the life events of major life events of Gandhiji. So regarding his policy, the basic policy was he followed was the non-violence and the peaceful kind of struggle, and also the with his leadership, the Indian National Congress in 1921 from onwards, he led nationwide campaigns for various social causes and for achieving the Swaraj or self-rule. So this is regarding Gandhiji's details, and we are moving to the next topic, which is the details of Hitler. So Hitler was the Chancellor of Germany from 1933 to 1945. Hitler enna oru nedavu Chancellor of Germany എന്നൊരു ഒരു ഒരു ലേബലിലാണ് അറിയപ്പെട്ടിരുന്നത്. ഫ്രം 1933 to 1945, ആൻഡ് ഹി ഇനിഷ്യേറ്റഡ് ദി സെക്കൻഡ് വേൾഡ് വാർ ഇൻ യൂറോപ്പ് വിത്ത് ദി ഇൻവേഷൻ ഓഫ് പോളണ്ട് ഇൻ സെപ്റ്റംബർ 1939. സോ ഇറ്റ് മീൻസ് ദാറ്റ് ഹി ഇനിഷ്യേറ്റഡ് ദി സെക്കൻഡ് വേൾഡ് വാർ. സോ ഹീ ബിലോങ്സ് ടു എ കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് എ ഡിക്റ്റേറ്റർഷിപ്പ് ഓർ എ കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് എ റൂളർ during the World War II, and he initiated the Second World War in Europe with the invasion of Poland in September 1939. And his autobiography Mein Kampf, which means my struggle, promoted pan-Germanism, anti-Semitism, and also anti-communism. So this his autobiography was provided, or it gave regarding this, promoted this kind of points. First one was pan-Germanism, second one was anti-Semitism, and the third one was the anti-communism. And he is notorious for the Holocaust, which is considered on one of the greatest atrocities committed against humanity, and at least 5.5 million Jews were killed in the name of ethnic cleansing. So it is very pathetic way in during that time, especially the World War II, in which with the leadership of Hitler, they killed about 5.5 million Jews during that time with the name of this ethnic cleansing. So 5.5 million Jews ne oru konnedutha oru ruler aayirunnu Hitler ennu oru nedavum. So ivide parayunnathu endanengil the mindset or their intention of dealing the problems or the struggles, especially while we compare Hitler with Gandhiji, we can see that Hitler was more aggressive, very aggressive than Gandhiji, in which Gandhiji only followed the peaceful kind of struggle, whereas Hitler followed the kind of this very aggressive, very intrinsic or extrinsic way of the struggle. Okay, so the inhumanity unleashed in the gas chambers, which were called the disinfection areas, was unimaginable. So it is also an activity done by Hitler during that time, with the inhumanity unleashed in the gas chambers. So it is very we can say the brutal way of treating the enemies in a very pathetic manner. So then it is like a we can say it is unimaginable in its nature. And also he argued for racial purity and believed that the impure races had to be annihilated, and he was heavily influenced by Charles Darwin and Herbert Spencer. So his influences were Charles Darwin and Herbert Spencer. So we have another influencer of Gandhiji, who is the basically Tolstoy, Leo Tolstoy. So here we have the major influences of Hitler, who are the two persons, who are the Charles Darwin and also Herbert Spencer. And he applied their theories of natural selection and survival of the fittest systematically to his project of ethnic cleansing. So this kind of ethnic cleansing was the project or the process done by Hitler during that time. And this is not a very simple process. It is just like a very brutal way of treating the enemies in a very all these activities are we can say that they are unimaginable. We cannot imagine the kind of brutal way of treating the enemies done by the group of people which is led by Hitler. So his kind of process was like, we can call it as a ethnic cleansing. And also he applied the theories by these two persons, especially these two influences, Charles Darwin, which is the theory which is related to Charles Darwin, which is the survival of the fittest, and also the theory which is related to Herbert Spencer, which is the natural selection. So with the help of these two theories, he formulated a kind of activities, a kind of policies in order to treat the enemies in a very brutal way. So for example, the kind of this gas chamber, the treatment with the help of this gas chamber is an example for this brutal way of treating the enemies. And this process of the process of treating the enemies in a very brutal way is regarded as the ethnic cleansing by Hitler. Then he was a powerful speaker who realized the role of rituals and spectacle in mass mobilization, and the red banners with the swastika and also the Nazi salute with the ritualized rounds of applause after his speeches were all parts of his spectacle of power. Finally, he killed himself to avoid capture by the Soviets. So, ഒരു ദാരുണമായ ഒരു അന്ത്യമായിരുന്നു ആരുടെ ഹിറ്റ്ലറിൻ്റെ. എങ്ങനെയാണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും അറിയുന്നതായിരിക്കാം, ഹി കിൽഡ് ഹിംസെൽഫ് ടു അവോയ്ഡ് ക്യാപ്ചർ ബൈ ദി സോവിയറ്റ്. സോ ഒരു ഡിക്റ്റേറ്റർ, ഒരു റൂളർ എന്ന രീതിക്ക് ആളുടെ ഒരു അഭിമാന പ്രശ്നമായിരുന്നു എന്ത്, സ്വയം മരിച്ചാൽ ഒന്നുകൂടി ഒരു മേജർ പോയിൻ്റായിട്ട് എപ്പോഴും നിലനിൽക്കും. ബട്ട് ഇഫ് ഹി വാസ് കിൽഡ് ബൈ എനി അതർ പേഴ്സൺ, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് റിഗാർഡ് ആസ് എ കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് എ ബ്ലാക്ക് മാർക്ക് ഇൻ ഹിസ് ബയോഗ്രഫി. സോ ഹി വാസ് വെരി കണ്ണിങ് പേഴ്സൺ ഇൻ ഹിസ് നേച്ചർ. ഹി ഫോർമുലേറ്റഡ് ദി കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് ദീസ് ആക്ടിവിറ്റീസ്, എത്നിക് ക്ലൻസിങ് ആക്ടിവിറ്റീസ്, ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഡിസ്ട്രോയ് ദി എനിമീസ് കൺട്രീസ് ആൻഡ് ചലഞ്ചഡ് മെനി കൺട്രീസ് പീപ്പിൾ. And at last he killed himself to avoid capture by the Soviets. So ഒരു ദാരുണമായ അന്ത്യം തന്നെയായിരുന്നു എന്ന് നമുക്കൊരു ഓവറോൾ നോക്കുമ്പോൾ ഹിറ്റ്ലറിൻ്റെ ഒരു ലൈഫ് സ്റ്റോറി നോക്കുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ പറ്റും. Then regarding, so we discussed about the major two personalities, especially regarding Gandhiji and Hitler, their major life events, their policies, how they treated they focused on their challenges during their lifetime. So this is regarding the major points regarding these two personalities. So now we are moving to this chapter, an introduction to the chapter in the textbook itself, from in the page number 135. So this letter assumes significance in contemporary times when violence against humanity continues in disguised and sanitized forms, and there is a growing mistrust between nations and communities on an unprecedented scale globally, and also nations and their leaders are becoming ഇൻക്രീസിംഗ്ലി ഇൻടോളറൻ്റ് ഓഫ് ഡിഫറൻസ്. സോ ഇവിടെ നമുക്കുള്ളത് രണ്ട് കൺട്രീസ് അത് ലീഡ് ചെയ്ത രണ്ട് ലീഡേഴ്സിനെ കുറിച്ചുള്ള ഒരു ചാപ്റ്ററാണ്. എസ്പെഷ്യലി ഇത് പറയുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് ഫോക്കസ് ചെയ്യേണ്ടി വരുന്നത് എസ്പെഷ്യലി ഇന്ത്യ എന്നൊരു നമ്മുടെ രാജ്യത്തിൻ്റെ ഒരു ലീഡറായിട്ട് ഗാന്ധിജിയെയും റെപ്രസെൻ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നതോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ ജർമ്മൻ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു പോളണ്ട് എന്നൊരു ഒരു യൂറോപ്യൻ ഒരു രാജ്യത്തിൻ്റെ മൊത്തത്തിലൊരു റെപ്രസെൻറ്റേഷൻ ആയിട്ട് ഹിറ്റ്ലർ എന്നൊരു ഒരു ലീഡറിനെ നമുക്ക് ഫോക്കസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും. സോ ദെയർ ആറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ഇൻ ഡീലിംഗ് ഓർ എഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് ദെയർ എനിമീസ് വാസ് എൻറ്റയർലി ഡിഫറെൻ്റ് ലൈക്ക് ടു എക്സ്ട്രീംസ് ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് എക്സ്ട്രീംസ് ഇൻ ദെയർ നേച്ചർ. സോ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ മേജർ ഡിഫറൻസ് ഇൻ ദ മൈൻഡ് സെറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഈവൻ ഇൻ ഗാന്ധിസ് ഓൺ കൺട്രി വൺ ക്യാൻ ബി ലിങ്കേർഡ് ഓഫ് ഫോർ ബീങ് എ ദളിറ്റ് ഓർ ഫോർ കൺസ്യൂമിംഗ് ബീഫ്. This short and crisp letter which Gandhi wrote to Hitler raises his genuine concerns of the sake of humanity. So ee letteril kude Gandhijiyude intention nu parayunnathu humanity enna oru sambhavathe adine kooduthal focus kodukkan vendiyulla oru letter aanu aarku Hitler enna oru nethavinu. So here we can see that in the last chapter also Chaplin also focused on this kind of humanity and democracy and to reunite all to fight against the world wars again. So here also Gandhiji advise or give some kind of instructions to Adolf Hitler to concerns regarding the sake of humanity. And the letter written during the Second World War after Germany's occupation of Czechoslovakia is a plea to stop the war, and Gandhi mentions his method of non-violence which he strongly believes in the best form of റെസിസ്റ്റൻസ്. സോ ഈ ലെറ്റർ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഹിറ്റ്ലർ എന്നൊരു നേതാവിനോട് ടു ഒരു അഡ്വൈസ് എന്ന രീതിയിൽ അന്ന് നടന്നിരുന്ന എസ്പെഷ്യലി ദി വാർ അതിനെ ഒന്ന് സ്റ്റോപ്പ് ചെയ്യുക ഒന്ന് അവസാനിപ്പിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടി ഒരു ലെറ്ററായിട്ടാണ് ഇതിനെ കണ്ടിരുന്നത് ഈ ലെറ്ററിനെ നമുക്ക് കാണാൻ പറ്റുക. ദെൻ ഗാന്ധിജി മെൻഷൻസ് ഹിസ് മെത്തേഡ് ഓഫ് നോൺ വയലൻസ് which he strongly believes is the best form of resistance. So in this lecture he gives the promotes the his kind of resistance which is the non violence, and he mentions in this this method in this lecture, and also he strongly believed that this is the best form of resistance, and he wrote two letters to Hitler, both of which were not delivered to him as they were intercepted by the British government. So actually this letters was not received or was not sent to Hitler because the British government was intercepted these letters. Then the first letter was written prior to Hitler's invasion of Poland, which marks the beginning of the Second World War. In that letter Gandhiji places the major topic on Hitler to prevent a massive war, the will to reduce the humanity to a savage state, and also he urges to Hitler to take the recourse to an international tribunal for an amicable settlement of the issues at stake. So this is regarding this this chapter which is the letter to Hitler by Gandhiji. So in the letters can be divided into two letters. So both the intention of these letters was to give some kind of information, some kind of advice to Hitler to stop the world war second, especially the Second World War, to bring back the Germany's occupation of Czechoslovakia, and also to give some kind of advice to Hitler regarding the World War Second during that time. So basically these letters can be traced by in its nature. We can see that these letters gives a kind of advice to Hitler regarding especially he in this letter Gandhiji gives his method, promotes his methods, especially the method of non-violence, the peaceful form of struggle, to Hitler, And basically, these letters was not at all effective because Hitler was not. There is an interception between these letters which was sent to Hitler, and the British government intercepted this letter. And so this is just like a form of chapter only, and it gives a clear idea regarding the advice of Gandhi to Hitler. So that's regarding this chapter. Just an introduction to this chapter. So in this class we discussed about the introduction to this chapter itself, which is the letter to Adolf Hitler by M.K. Gandhi. Firstly, we discussed about the Gandhi and the major just like a comparison between Gandhiji and Adolf Hitler, and also then we focused on Gandhiji, a very brief lifeline of Gandhiji. Then we discussed about Adolf Hitler, his policies and his lifeline. Then we just go through the outline to this chapter itself, which is the letter. So that's for today. We will discuss this chapter in the next class onwards. So from the page number 133 to 135 that we focused on today. So go through all these content in the textbook from the chapter number 4 in the module 3. So that's for today. Thank you. Happy learning.